Hello, my name is Ilana and I'm a senior in mechanical engineering from Orange County, California. I'm excited to be your virtual tour guide today as we explore Purdue engineering and student life on campus. We'll start here at Armstrong Hall. Armstrong houses the aeronautical and astronautical engineering, material science and engineering, and multidisciplinary engineering majors, as well as the Women in Engineering program, Minority Engineering program, and First Year Engineering. Fun fact, Purdue is home to the first University Women in Engineering program and the first chapter of the National Society of Black Engineers. Stepping inside Armstrong Hall, we are now in the Herman and Hetty Kurz Atrium. You'll often see it set up like this for big events, like guest speakers, award ceremonies, research poster fairs, and special announcements from the Dean of Engineering. When it's not prepped for a big event, there are tables and chairs set up as a study space. In the mornings, I like to grab a coffee from Amelia's Cafe in the basement, then come back here and sit up next to the giant windows to work on homework. During finals week, the different organizations give out coffee, snacks, and other free things here to help us study. As we walk down the main hallway, you'll see the EPICS lab space. In EPICS, student teams are paired with community partners to design, build, and implement solutions to human, community, and environmental issues. You can participate in EPICS regardless of major or year in school. Because it has such a wide variety of projects, you have access to tons of different resources, including 3D printers, electrical engineering devices, machining and fabrication equipment, and design software and workshops. When I participated in EPICS, I took a workshop on iOS app development, and I have had friends design everything from prosthetics to a penny press, and travel all over the world to implement their designs. In the basement of Armstrong is the Ideas to Innovation, or I2I lab, where you'll likely have your Intro to Engineering class. In this class, you'll work on teams to design solutions to engineering problems, learn quantitative reasoning and mathematical modeling skills, code, and learn about the many engineering disciplines Purdue has to offer. One thing I always liked about this classroom is that all of the walls are whiteboards, which was really helpful since you do a lot of your work in class in teams. As we exit the building named for Purdue alum Neil Armstrong, you can see his footprints and try running along them to feel like you're on the moon. These moon boot prints are cast from actual moon boots from his walk during Apollo 11. Students like to take pictures with Neil for graduation or just on a whim, and you'll often see him sporting a beanie during the winter. Now, we'll turn and walk toward the engineering mall. Along this walkway are the buildings for various engineering majors, as well as the Purdue University Student Health Center, or PUSH. Here on the left is Hampton Hall, home to the School of Civil Engineering, which is ranked 5th in the country. One unique feature of Hampton is this 3-story waterfall that powers the hydraulics and hydrology labs, which uses this waterfall to feed into a working river model used in class experimentation and demonstrations. Next up is Forney Hall of Chemical Engineering. It was recently renovated to add a collaboration lobby for students to use, and even though I'm not in chemical engineering, I like to go there to study with my friends sometimes. One common misconception is that once you get into your major-specific classes, you will only have classes in your own building. But I've actually had semesters where I had a lecture or two in Forney, but none in the Mechanical Engineering building. Now we have arrived on the Engineering Mall. You are looking at what is formerly known as the Purdue Mall Water Sculpture, a gift from the class of 1939, but most of us just call it the Engineering Fountain. When the weather is nice, I usually come here and set up a hammock or have a picnic with my friends. In the spring semester, the Mechanical Engineering Ambassadors hold recess here, where students can come play games or just relax to take a break from classes in the middle of the day. On a hot summer day, you might choose to take part in the campus tradition of going on a fountain run. You start at the Engineering Fountain, take a dip in the pond next to the bell tower, drink from the Lion's Head Fountain, step in the Memorial Fountain, and run through Loeb Fountain, the one you see here, and then run through them all in reverse order to end back at the Engineering Fountain. Even if this isn't really your thing for the average day, it's tradition to do a fountain run during Boiler Gold Rush when you first begin your time at Purdue and do one around graduation as you prepare to leave. This is the Material Science and Electrical Engineering building, a bit of a misnomer as it mainly serves electrical and computer engineering. Inside is a Starbucks and a killer view of the Engineering Fountain during every season. It is also connected to underground tunnels that lead to the parking garage, the physics building, and the electrical engineering building for when you don't want to brave the winter cold. MSEE is usually my go-to when I have a half hour to kill and want to get something done, since it's so centrally located to the other engineering building and it's easy on the eyes. Next door is the Electrical Engineering Building, one of the oldest engineering buildings on campus. Electrical and computer engineering are ranked 9th and 10th in the country, respectively. EE-129 is a classroom where I have not so fond memories of exams and tough first year classes, but I have better memories of going to the lounge in the basement run by the Electrical Engineering Honor Society, Eta Kappa Nu, with friends to grab a cheap coffee or donut and hang out on the couch after those classes. Underneath the Electrical Engineering Building, the annex is home to Indiana's first and only nuclear reactor. It produces only about 1/1,000,000th as much energy as a commercial reactor, so it's completely safe. Just recently, in 2019, it was licensed as the first entirely digital nuclear reactor in the country, which allows researchers to quickly obtain much more accurate data and better handle maintenance. Once trained, engineering students can actually work with the nuclear reactor. Responsible for the nuclear reactor is the School of Nuclear Engineering, which will be relocated to this new building once complete. Here you can see a rendering of Dudley Hall, part of the Gateway Engineering Complex to be completed for the 2022-23 school year. This new complex will have design studios, instructional labs, and research space for a variety of programs. Now we've come to my home, the Mechanical Engineering Building. ME is the first building at Purdue to be constructed according to LEED standards, which means it adheres to high standards of environmental sustainability. Purdue ME is also ranked 8th in the country. Here, multiple racing teams have their workspaces, such as Formula SAE and Formula Baja. Something I have always loved about Purdue Engineering is how collaborative it is. If I'm sitting at the study tables, working on the same problem as someone next to me, even if I don't know them, it's common to help each other out. Several ME organizations have offices on the second floor, and I've spent countless hours studying and hanging out in the ambassador office with friends. Between the study tables, organization offices, and the tutoring rooms for mechanical engineering core classes, it's usually a safe bet that the second floor of ME is where you'll find me on a given weekday afternoon. Located a short walk from the engineering mall, we have now arrived at Grissom Hall. Grissom is home to the School of Industrial Engineering, which is ranked 3rd in the nation. The building is over 100 years old, but was recently renovated to better allow for student study space and modern lab space. We'll now take a quick detour to Discovery Park. Discovery Park spans 40 acres and houses research facilities dedicated to solving interdisciplinary challenges. It also houses the Martin Jischke Hall of Biomedical Engineering. This year, the new innovation wing opened, which added nearly 30,000 square feet of research labs, student design spaces, and classrooms. A lot of incoming students think that you are confined to only work on projects within your major, but I actually spent a lot of my sophomore year in this building as president of a medical device design club. Here you see a rendering for the new Agricultural and Biological Engineering Building, which should be completed in late 2020. This newly renovated 5-story building will include classrooms and teaching labs, spaces and resources for student clubs, and labs in a variety of academic areas, including machinery, sensing, fluid power, computation, water and environment, bioprocess engineering, food engineering, and biological engineering. Purdue is proud to house the top-ranked agricultural and biological engineering program in the country. For this segment of the tour, we'll talk about life on campus. Most likely, the first thing you'll do on campus is Boiler Gold Rush, or BGR, Purdue's new student orientation program. BGR is a great way to make new friends, learn your way around campus, and have fun before starting classes. You can also choose to volunteer as a team leader or supervisor in future years to help new students move into their residence halls and lead them during BGR. This is a photo from my BGR group of when I was a team leader. Your first year on campus, you'll probably live in a residence hall, where you'll have easy access to all of your classes and the dining courts, not to mention lots of new people to meet. This is a room in Windsor Hall, which is where I lived during my sophomore year. My specific building is where Amelia Earhart lived when she was a faculty member. Although my room wasn't decorated quite as well as this one, I loved how beautiful the building itself was, that it had housed an important person in Purdue history, and that there were tunnels straight to Windsor Dining Court, so I could avoid leaving the building on cold winter days. Most of your classes will be within 10 to 15 minutes from your residence hall, so the majority of students choose to walk around campus. I like to bike to class when I can, but many students also skateboard or scooter, and there are several free bus routes around campus that can take you to classes or back to your residence hall. This is the class of 1950 lecture hall, which is similar to other lecture halls on campus where you may take some of your larger freshman classes, such as calculus, chemistry, or physics. For these large STEM classes, you will usually have a recitation, which is a 30-person class led by a graduate TA to review concepts and do practice problems. Due to the coronavirus pandemic, large lectures will likely be online this fall, and smaller classes may use these spaces to allow for social distancing between students. This photo is from an electrical and computer engineering research lab. Many students choose to pursue research while on campus, and you can get involved as early as your freshman year. Engineering students can get involved in many kinds of research, from deeply technical topics within their discipline, to interdisciplinary pursuits, to areas very different from what they study. For example, I have a friend in biomedical engineering who worked on automating a medical test to help pregnant women, while another in civil engineering studied multidisciplinary policy solutions. Instead of showing you the study abroad office, which is helpful but not super exciting to look at, I figured I'd share a couple of photos from my study abroad experiences. I was fortunate enough to study abroad twice, first to Peru for 6 weeks over the summer to work on my Spanish minor, and then to China for a semester to work on my mechanical engineering major. Study abroad programs range anywhere from 1 week to 8 months and can be related to a wide range of topics, within or outside of your major. One myth many people worry about is that engineers cannot study abroad and still graduate on time. At Purdue, this is absolutely false. I am still able to graduate in 4 years, and this is the norm. Purdue encourages studying abroad by giving out scholarships and financial aid based on need and the length of time you go, with the goal of being financially accessible for all students. Unlike high school, your classes will not likely all be back-to-back. In between classes, many students go to the Wilmoth Active Learning Center, or WALC, to study or do homework because of its central location to many academic buildings. The room on the left is a silent study room, but other floors have collaborative study spaces like what you see on the right, which is where I usually go to work. Another great place to study is the Kroc Leadership Center. This building is located on the residential side of campus, so it's a good place to go to escape distractions in your residence hall. Kroc is also where the Student Government, Civic Engagement and Leadership Development Center, and student activities and organizations offices are. There is an Amazon pickup center inside where you can have packages sent, and next door are Starbucks and Third Street Market if you need any coffee to fuel your studies. When you've finished your work or want a break, hammocking is a favorite pastime of Purdue students on nice fall and spring days. If you're especially creative, you may be able to fit all your friends in one tree like this group. Next up is the Cordova Recreational Sports Center, or the CoRec, which is the center for all student recreational and wellness activities on campus. The CoRec has fitness equipment, tracks, basketball courts, swimming pools, climbing walls, and multi-purpose rooms, offers a variety of fitness classes, and runs the intramural sports leagues. On top of that, it also offers wellness services such as nutritionists, physical therapists, massage therapy, and cooking demonstrations. The facilities are open from 5 a.m. to midnight, so you can go any time of day that fits your lifestyle. I spend most of my time here at dance practices in the multi-purpose rooms, but when I venture to the indoor track, I've seen my professors running by me on multiple occasions. Football games in Rossade Stadium are a big part of the fall semester, and night games like this one are rare but considered to be some of the most fun of the season. Another fun aspect of the fall semester is the Thursday Farmers Market on campus. Every Thursday, local vendors set up in Memorial Mall with tons of fresh produce and other yummy goods like pastries and cuisine from all over the world. It's a weekly tradition for many people, myself included, to meet up with friends here for lunch and sit outside to enjoy the nice weather. Basketball games in Mackey Arena are a highlight of the spring semester. Mackey is widely regarded as the loudest venue in the Big Ten, and I recommend you check out a game instead of just taking my word for it. With such a diverse student body, I highly recommend attending cultural events whenever you get the chance. This photo is from Dia de los Muertos, a holiday celebrated on November 1st each year. This celebration is put on by the Latino Cultural Center. Other cultural centers on campus include the Black Cultural Center, Asian American and Asian Resource and Cultural Center, LGBTQ Center, and the Native American Educational and Cultural Center. In the spring, a Hindu festival called Holi is celebrated by throwing colored water and powders on each other. Purdue puts on its own celebration on Memorial Mall each year. Another experience unique to Purdue is that in your time here, there's a decent chance you'll get to see an astronaut. We're known as the Cradle of Astronauts and have graduated 25 astronauts to date. An outreach event called Purdue Space Day is put on each year to celebrate that tradition and encourage young kids to get excited about space and engineering. At this event, a former astronaut is always invited to speak to the participants and their leaders. The final event I'll highlight is one of the biggest events of the year, Purdue's Grand Prix, where a variety of student organizations build and race their own go-karts for what is called the greatest spectacle in college racing. Even though a go-kart race didn't originally seem that exciting to me, once I had friends building one themselves, I couldn't help but get hyped up to cheer them on. As an engineer, there are plenty of opportunities like this to get involved and gain practical experience while having fun and making friends. This concludes the virtual tour of Purdue Engineering and Student Life. If you have any questions about life as a Purdue engineer, feel free to reach out to the Office of Future Engineers using the contact information shown on the screen. Thanks for joining me, and don't forget, boiler up, hammer down, and hail Purdue!